And so you have come, bearing your sin like a badge of honor. What do you seek, Pale Rider?
The return of mankind.
To a barren planet shorn of life. Oh, humans are weak and simple. They would not survive this resurrection, nor do they deserve it.
That is not ours to judge. I do this to spare war from the Council's punishment.
And what of the Nephilim? Would you save but one and not the rest?
The Nephilim are a threat to the balance.
If we had taken Eden, none of this would have happened. Yet you rode against us, slaughtered our flesh, then bound our souls in your amulet.
Who are you?
I think you know. Once, you called me brother.
Absalom.
I have forsaken that name. Now, I am corruption. The day you raised your scythe against us, I was born, and soon I will be all. The tree of life has fallen to my darkness, from withered root to fruitless limb, and even death himself will not escape it!
What defines a soul? Some call it the spark within that fights the darkness, that burns for life itself. But what of Death, who became the Reaper on the day he slaughtered the Nephilim? He killed his brother, his comrades, and Absalom.
Death! Why do you slay your own?
The Nephilim have no claim to Eden.
There are realms for angels and demons. Why not for us?
Eden belongs to man.
It belongs to those who take it!
The eons have not answered the question. Was it worth it?
Brother.
That one moment.
No!
Begot corruption. And crowned him Kinslayer. The bitter victory could not be undone.
Ah, the Pale Rider. Isn't it odd that so many have come here by your hand? And yet you so rarely visit the Dead Kingdom.
I had no plan to visit this wretched place. I sought the Tree of Life, I found it. Now I'm here.
The tree is no destination, my friend. Only a portal to other worlds. If the tree is what you seek, then you have arrived.
That I have been betrayed.
Not so hasty. The tree is wise beyond imagining. If it brought you here, then here is where you belong. Perhaps I can help.
I doubt it.
You would be wise to heed me. I have a merchant's skill to grant your deepest desire. Tell me, Rider, what do you seek?
I would redeem my brother, restore the balance.
Yes, I have heard the tale. Your brother rode, though no call was given, and mankind paid the price.
Guard your tongue, merchant.
I give no judgment, friend. Only pass on that which I have been told. You were right to seek the tree.
But it is only the gateway. What you seek is the Well of Souls.
The Well of Souls can restore humanity.
And more. The well channels the dead into this kingdom from every world, above and below. It is also how souls are brought back into creation when they are ready to be reborn.
You still haven't said what you are.
The history of my people was burned to ash along with our world. Forgotten even by those who destroyed them. Now, only the smoke remains. We were not the first. Nor will we be the last. It is the way of things.
The way of things is balance.
And what balances life? Nothingness. Or corruption. Eventually, it consumes us all.
So it would seem. None of this explains what you're doing here.
I am merely a humble merchant with a taste for the finer things. In life, and in death. I am Ostagoth, and it would amuse me to offer you my wares.
Tree of life, tree of death, portals to other worlds. I know none of this. How is it I have remained so blind, or does your tongue only spit lies?
Much was kept from the Nephilim, and from the Four.
Why?
Because power must be tempered with ignorance. If the Nephilim knew the true nature of the tree, all would have perished.
I forsook the Nephilim, became a warrior for the balance, even killed my own people. I protect these worlds, you and the tree, yet still I remain in the dark.
Forsaken, yes. Forgotten? No. The Nephilim live on in you. But what do I know? I am but a simple merchant.
What if I wish to return to the Forge Lands?
The Tree of Life has many portals, Rider. Some may help you retrace your path. Many portals are closed, but the ones to the Forge Lands remains open. All new items! From lands near and far.
Pretend that I believe you. Where should my search begin?
You must scale the Serpent's Peak and summon the Eternal Throne. There, the Lord of Bones slumbers. He will guide you to the well, or he will have your soul. Before you go, horseman, consider this. My people may be lost, but their relics yet remain. You may come across them in your travels. They are worthless to most, but valuable to me. Return them, and I will trade relic for coin.
This is no place for a horse. I have to go alone. This is no place for a horse. I have to go alone. This is no place for a horse. see.
Huh? items, if you have the coin.
Go. Show me the way. Go. Chancellor sent you. Well, horseman. I've beaten death once, and I can do it again.
I've no idea what you're talking about.
Of course not. You still reek of hope. You couldn't have met the Chancellor.
The Chancellor doesn't sound like much.
For ages, his tongue has dripped venom into the dead king's ears. He all but sits upon the eternal throne, demanding service.
Who are you?
I am the Master of Blades, and all that remains of the warrior once called Draven.
and the kingdom of man. I should have passed through the well of souls long ago. But I won my freedom in the arena, only to fall beneath the dead king's whip. You would have done well in my army. The Pale Rider in the flesh.
Disturbs the Lord of Bones without say of his Chancellor. A rider? In the kingdom of the dead? No, no, this will never do.
I must speak with the Lord of Bones.
That is not possible.
My lord attends his realm, a burden beyond even your ken, horseman.
And what is your use as a doorstop?
There is but one way to draw him from his slumber. The Gilded Arena. Here, mortals are offered a last chance to earn freedom from the grave. A boon that includes an audience with the king. Defeat the arena's champion and return here with its skull. His Majesty will grant you an audience.
And where is this arena?
Fret not, horseman. We have already arrived. Yes?
Let me speak to the Lord of Bones, and I will spare your champion, and perhaps you as well, Chancellor.
You cannot slay that which is already dead. But you're welcome to try in the arena.
Forget what I said about sparing you, doorkeeper. Tell me about the King of the Dead.
His reign is eternal. His word is law. And his time is invaluable. I ensure that he need only speak with those who are worthy.
Then you must rarely see him, Chancellor.
Oh, enough. Do take care in the arena, horseman. Should anything happen to you, I'm not sure if I could live with myself. Still more questions. What is it now?
you get here?
A merchant knows many roads. Not all of them are shared with horsemen.
Please, take a look.
His cause. Speak, challenger.
I'm here to defeat your champion.
And so all challengers boast that most leave in torment.
Their souls burn from existence, and our champion all the stronger for it.
Enough! Bring out your champion!
There is power in this one, power enough to do as he claims.
But our champion is no cur to be summoned at will. You must draw him forth. This altar holds his power. The souls of all he has slain and consumed. Three animus stones must be placed therein, and our champion will arrive.